Hello, I'm Diego Pizarro, and welcome to another episode of The Big Time, your home for entertainment news. And guess what? It's not 2021. It's actually 1961 again. Fox is taking a page right out of history and teaming up with Warner Brothers Animation and executive producer Elizabeth Banks to begin work on Bedrock, a reboot of the beloved animated sitcom The Flintstones. The adult animation show that was announced almost 2 years ago is going to be set 20 years after the original series and will follow a grown-up Pebbles Flintstone, who will be voiced by Elizabeth Banks. The Flintstones began airing on September 30th, 1960 and lasted till April Fool's 1966. The show's popularity continued even after it stopped airing, and until The Simpsons came on the scene, The Flintstones was the most financially successful animated series in history, and its theme song became infamous for getting stuck in people's heads everywhere. The show centers around the lives of the Flintstones and their neighbors, the Rubbles. They live in a romanticized version of the Stone Age. What made the show famous was putting everyday modern life in a Stone Age setting. The reboot seems to be an attempt to bring the Flintstones out of the Stone Age, so to speak, giving the show a more modern feel, I guess. It centers around a 20-year-old Pebble as she begins her career as her father, Fred, nears retirement. With the Stone Age giving way to a new Bronze Age, our beloved Bedrock residents are finding the evolution hard to get used to. The pilot will be written by Jurassic World and DC Superhero Girls writer Lindsay Kearns and produced by Brownstone Productions. So, as far as my opinion on this, I gotta be honest with you. I'm getting really tired of all these reboots, sequels, and prequels being made in the movie and TV world these days. Have we just completely run out of ideas? Why can't we just move on from the past? If I want to watch The Flintstones, I'll watch the original. But I want my new releases to actually be original. When I'm an old man telling kids how much better my generation was, I don't want to have to say, "Oh, we had the best movies on TV when I was young, not like the rubbish you kids have today. We had the Flintstones reboot, we had the Star Wars reboot." It's just lame. Look, I love the Flintstones. I grew up watching them on Teletoon Retro on Saturday mornings when I was a kid. It's a classic, but it's like, been there, done that. Let's try something new. And people will say, "Well, this reboot isn't for you." But who was really going around clamoring for a more adult-oriented Flintstones? And even if you tried to bring it back to a more kid-friendly format, I just don't think the Stone Age gimmick is going to work in 2021. I mean, way back in 1994, a Flintstones movie was released, and it bombed. The original show was only 34 years old at the time, and it didn't resonate then. Now, over 60 years after the original airing of the show, it's supposed to resonate any better? And what bothers me most is we're in a golden age of adult animation. There's Rick and Morty, Bob's Burgers, Archer, South Park, the list goes on. So why does Fox feel the need for a more adult-oriented Flintstones? But we'll have to wait and see. For all I know, this could be great. What do you think? Do you think this reboot has the potential to be a classic? On to some more TV news, and since it's not a reboot, it must be comic books. Netflix has released a trailer for the upcoming Jim Mickle adaptation of the DC comic book Sweet Tooth, written by Jeff Lemire. Robert Downey Jr. and Susan Downey are being brought on as executive producers. The series is set in the years after an event known as the Great Crumble, a semi-apocalyptic disaster that almost destroys humanity and leads to the arrival of human-deer hybrids. The show centers around a young human-deer hybrid named Sweet Tooth and his friendship with a lonely man. The pair goes out on crazy adventures through the dangerous world of the seismic event left in its wake, running from people who want to kill the boy and in search of some kind of home.
"They don't like you because you're different. Just about you and me anymore. You have to be brave.
The series co-developer Jim Mickle is behind movies like 2014's Cold in July and 2019's In the Shadow of the Moon. Based on the trailer, this series looks strange for DC, like nothing they've ever done before. It's great to see that both the comic book giants are stepping outside of their comfort zone, Marvel with WandaVision and DC with Sweet Tooth. It seems this series is focusing more on personal relationships and accepting people for who they are, than the typical DC fare. The trailer doesn't reveal much, but its intense acting and more toned down, less superhero-like world shows DC is taking a big risk with this series, and I can't wait to see how it turns out. Make sure you let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and thank you very much for watching The Big Time.